Hey guys, welcome back in CodeSphere. So this is the very first video of social media app using Firebase 2020. Fine guys. So during this video, we will create a Firebase project and then we will connect it with our Android project. And you guys may be thinking that why I'm starting this from very scratch, because I just want to show everything and I just want to make every point clear at every stage. Fine. So we will start from very scratch and then we will do things step by step. Fine guys. So as you can see on the screen that this is Firebase console, and here I have logged in from my email account. You can also log in. Fine, that is very easy process. Then guys, after this you can see this kind of window, and you can see that this is CodeSphere, Firestore, demo app. This is just some projects on which I'm working. So first of all, simply click on the button add project, and yes, we came on this. So what here we need to do is we have to give a name. So I would like to give a name of social media. Fine guys, and that is just a unique key. You have to do nothing with it, just simply click on the button continue. And now we came on this window. After this you have to click on continue, then account. So default account for Firebase, that is. After this simply click on this create project. So now you can see that our project is creating. So guys, in this app we are going to have a lot of things like chatting functionality, stories functionality. You can ask questions, you can do posts, likes, comments, share, and request friends. You can make other people friend, you can unfriend them. Yes, so that is going to be a complete package of Android development, and you will learn a lot of cool things in Android development. And as you guys know that I try to keep things so simple. So now you can see that our project is synced. So click on the button continue, and now our new project is created successfully. Fine guys, so this is a very updated version of Firebase 2020. Now our plan is Spark, and there is all the features of Firebase, you can see that. So we will work on it later, but now simply click on this Android because we will work on Android. So yeah, here it is asking for Android package name guys. So simply you have to go back in Android Studio, and here you can see that this is Android Studio and we have to create a new project. Fine. So we will just start with empty activity, then next, and we will give it name social media. Fine guys, then simply click on finish. So here you can see that the Gradle build is syncing. Yes, so now our project is successfully synced. So now it is still loading. Gradle build, configuring projects, and so as you can see guys that it is almost going to finish. Now our app is indexing, then symbols loading, waiting for build to finish. Actually we are already waiting, and yeah, so guys, as you can see that our app is successfully synced, and now we have got this mainactivity.java, and this is activity_main.xml file. And as you can see on the screen that this is just a very updated version of Android Studio. Fine guys, so what the Firebase is asking for, so this is asking for package name. So here we can get it, this is our package name. So simply copy it from here, and we have to go back in Firebase, and then guys you have to simply paste it here, and then you can give any optional name. So I would like to give the same social media, don't make any changes. And then guys, here you can see that it is asking for debug signing certificate SHA1. So guys, basically what this key do is that is required. It is you can see here it is saying that it is optional, but let me tell you, it is mandatory, because when you want to implement you know, whenever you want to implement authentication in your app, so you have to paste it, this signing report, I mean this SHA1 key, because it is required when you implement authentication. Fine guys, so make sure you add it. So here you can see that how we can get it. Simply click on this, let me show you again, click on this Gradle, then task, then Android, and then signing the port. So here you can see that we got this SHA1 key. Fine. So here is our SHA1 certificate. So simply copy it from here because we need it. And then you have to paste it here. Then Control plus V, then register app. Fine. So now you can see that it is loading and soon it will be done. So now what it is saying that you have to download a Google services JSON file. So simply click on the button download and here you can see that it is downloaded. Then click on it, then show in folder. Then guys, here you can see that simply you have to cut it from here and then go back in Android Studio and let me close all this stuff. So yes, after this simply click on this Android, go to project level and then social media, and then you have to paste it here in this app. So yes, and make sure guys that you should not change the name of this file, because if you will change, so Android Studio will not be able to detect it and it will create problem. So simply save it as it is, simply click on the button OK. So you can see that we have this JSON file here, and after this we have to go back in this Firebase database, and I mean Firebase, and then you have to click on the button next because you have added. Fine. So after this, here it is saying us to add this line in our Gradle build. So simply copy it from here and I will show you where you have to paste it. So again, change this to Android and change it to Android, then Gradle build, then this, and you have to paste it just below of this line. And fine, now 1 minute before syncing it, we have to add one more line. So again, copy this one, then again go back in Android Studio, and then here you have to add this line after this dependency. Fine. And wait one more second. After this you have to copy this analytics again, and then you have to go back and you have to paste that line here. Fine guys, now you can click on this button sync now. So after this, when you will click on the button sync now, so guys, it will take a little bit long time for syncing, because this time it is it will add the Firebase SDK and it will connect this app from the Firebase, so it may take little bit time, but that's fine. And in case guys that if you get any error, then let me know in comment section, I will try to reply as soon as I can. Yes, and that will be little bit longer playlist, but trust me that this your time and your effort will be worth it, because I will show you the best tutorials of Android development. So here you can see that our Gradle build is synced successfully, so it means that now our app is successfully connected to Firebase. And now go back in Firebase. So here it is also saying that finally press sync now in the bar and appears in this IDE. Fine, then click on next, and we can skip this step. So here you can see that we have this Firebase console. You can also read documentation, you can see the pricing of the app, that in the beginning we can start free and later you can grow as you can upgrade the plans, you can upgrade the plans as you want, depends on you. So here you can see that this is settings, this is authentication, and this is database. Actually Firebase makes everything easy for us, because when creating it from scratch is a little bit difficult, and also it is managing the bandwidth for Android app using backend services, it little bit costly, and also it is very difficult. So Firebase makes it easy for all of us, and the latest version of Firebase is almost ready to replace the backend service. Fine guys, so after this here what we have to do is you can also add it to Firebase after clicking on this tools, then Firebase. So here you can see this is assistant, and how can we check is yes, we can go here and simply click on this real-time database and then save and retrieve data. So you can see that it is showing the status. So now you can see that our app is connected successfully. Fine guys, so you can see that our app is connected successfully, and now it is saying that add real-time database to your app. So that is the things that we will do in upcoming tutorials. So guys, that is all for this tutorial. So as you can see that our app is connected successfully, there is no problem. So in case if you get any error, then let me know in comment section. And guys, please subscribe my channel because this is the very first part. In future, we will have a lot of parts and we will learn a lot of cool things. Chatting, stories, posts, user, friends, all these things will come in this app. And you can also ask questions like Kyora. You can reply to that question. You can save that questions personally. You have the option of privacy. So all these features will be live, will be in this playlist. So make sure you subscribe my channel and please press the bell icon so you will never miss any update. Guys, thank you for watching.